Hi, welcome to Easy Learning Economics. This is Dr. Carroll, PhD in Economics. In the part 1, we discussed the contestable markets under oligopoly. We discussed in detail that what is oligopoly, what are the features, and what are the advantages and disadvantages of oligopoly, how contestable market functions. I am going to discuss the oligopoly, the price leadership model. In this lecture, we discussed what is price leadership theory, what are the assumptions of price leadership theory, what is low-cost price leadership model, and what are the types of price leadership, and what is the importance of price leadership model, and what are the components which are responsible for price leadership model. So here I would like to suggest my one video, that is on oligopoly part 1, contestable market, in which we discussed in detail all about the oligopoly features, forms, characteristics, and the advantages, disadvantages, everything we discussed in the first part. So you must go through the first part of the oligopoly, that you will have a better idea about oligopolistic competition. For exam notes on economic related topics, you can visit my website easylearningeconomics.blogspot.com. So here we start that what is price leadership theory. In the form of oligopoly, there is only one dominant form. Initiate price strategies influences existing firms that it can determine the price for whole market and sets its price to maximize its profit, while the rest of small firms compete and decide their prices either close to or equal to the dominant firm settled price. For example, the most large airports are dominated by one airline. If one airline raises price, the other airline usually follow this. What are the conditions on the basis of the price leadership theory or model functions? That it is assumed that the rival firms are small. Entry to the industry is restricted. Products are homogeneous. Demand for industry is inelastic or very low elastic. The firms have almost similar cost. The firm is efficient in production of goods at lower opportunity cost. Price leadership theory, it means the smaller firms believe that the dominant firm has better information than others in the benefit of business. In the banking sector, small banks follow the interest rate changes made by the large banks. Price leadership refers to a situation where the dominant firm set up the prices of goods and services in the market. This generally happens when the goods are homogeneous. It means that there is no difference in the goods or services provided by the different firms. So customers don't have a preferences and chooses the lowest price. Mainly in the oligopolist market, it is followed. The oligopolist market is a market where the players are less. Dominant firm decide the price P, its marginal cost is this. MC touches the marginal revenue from below at this point. So other firms cost is this, that is higher, and they want to set their price at P1. Suppose if the dominant firm decide the price P, then the other firms should reduce their price in order to retain the existing share of market. Low cost price leadership model. The oligopolist firms with lower cost may set the lower price that other firms have to follow. Here you can see SC1, MC1 cost curve for low cost firm. This is the cost of the largest firm, and SC2 and MC2 cost curve for all rival firms. So this is the marginal cost and average cost of rival firms. OP2 is the unit cost for low cost firm, whereas OQ2 selling quantity at price OP2. So the largest firm with SC1 and marginal cost 1 produces OQ2 quantity, whereas OP3 unit cost for rival firms and producing OQ1 selling quantity at price OP3. The cost are almost the same for all firms. The industries with equal size of firm can use cost pill as pricing strategy and firm make charge certain percentage above average cost. A company following cost leadership strategy targets to establish competitive advantage by achieving the lowest operational cost in their sector. Some cost leadership examples include the McDonald's, Walmart, etc. So now we are going to discuss the types of price leadership. Barometric model. In this form of leadership, even a small firm can be a leader, which has identified the change market conditions through price, team, experiments, competitive intelligence and knowledge. The competitors believe in the decision of leading firm on the basis of assumption that the leading firm knows better about market outcomes that the rival firms will not discover on their own part, but they follow the leading firm under barometric model. The dominant firm leadership model. In this form of price leadership, the dominant firm deals in homogeneous product and has the control over major market share. If the dominant firm determines price according to opposite forces of demand and supply, the smaller firms to adjust their prices in order to retain the market share that they control. However, the dominant firm may charge price lower that might be unsustainable and hurting the rival firms. Such practices are illegal. The collisive model. Collisive model exists in oligopoly markets where group of firms leader collude to fix price for their product or services and rest of the firms follow that price. What is the importance of price leadership model? The importance of price leadership model is that the firm can opt out or reject the uncertain surrounding prices. The firm's own behavior is interdependent with rival firms. So what makes the company price leader? Best pricing team, competitive intelligence and knowledge about the market can be a price leader. It was all about the price leadership theory or price leadership model of oligopoly. Let me know your feedback or any future request in comment box. If you like this video, please click the subscribe button. Thanks for watching.